We are all going to die, but we're going to do it in very different ways from our ancestors, and even our grandparents and parents. Hi, I'm David, and this is Minute Death. Minute Earth. For much of human history, people died mostly from malnutrition and a few different types of infections. But those old school causes of death are becoming way less common today, thanks to some of the benefits of modernization, like access to clean water, food, basic medicine, and vaccines. And as long as we don't drop the ball, even fewer of us will die from them in the future. Of course, modernization itself is responsible for a lot of new causes of death today. Lots of people are dying from lung diseases caused by smoking and pollution, heart attacks and diabetes caused by unhealthier diets, and fatal accidents from so many cars on the road. In the future, though, as even more public health campaigns are adopted, as safety standards increase, and as cleaner forms of energy become more common, at least some of these modern types of deaths should decrease as well. But there's a second camp of modern deaths, too. People today are living longer than ever, so things that tend to kill old people, like certain types of cancers and dementia, are more common than ever. And lifespans are still increasing, so in the future, our risk of age-related deaths is likely only going to get bigger. There are other non-age-related causes of death that might also rack up an even bigger body count in the future than they do today, like increasingly large storms and wildfires driven by a warming climate, as well as wars and refugee crises associated with diminishing water resources. And it's possible that deadly pandemics will continue to emerge as humans continue to encroach into new habitats and get exposed to novel diseases. And those are just the things that are already happening. There are also wild cards that could take out a big chunk of us all at once. Like, you know, nuclear war, or cyber terrorism that takes down large swaths of infrastructure and disrupts basic services, or non-aligned AI run amok. All of which individually are still unlikely to happen, but as a whole are becoming more likely than ever before. But before we all retreat into our bunkers, let's think about this. 20 years ago, researchers thought that the leading cause of death in 2050 would be HIV, which had been on a rampage for more than a decade, and was able to integrate itself into our DNA so well that it was impossible to design a traditional vaccine against it. But really rapid scientific innovations created a totally new way to prevent getting the disease, and a totally new way to reduce its deadliness. As a result, HIV has gone from being a major growing cause of deaths worldwide, to a smaller declining one that is expected to continue to fall. So it is possible that we will be able to science our way out of some of the other oncoming death traps too. But unless we somehow figure out how to divorce our consciousness from the meat sack that surrounds it, we won't be able to defeat all of those death traps, and new ones will continue to pop up. In the future, assuming civilization continues developing, we probably won't die from the same things as our ancestors did. But that just means that we will die from something else. This video was made in partnership with Bill Gates. To learn more about how we can help improve the lives and health of people around the world, visit gatesnotes.com. Thanks, Bill!